My name is Jodell White, and I'm originally from Columbus, Ohio. Douglas is originally from Chicago, Illinois, and we moved here after Doug had a stroke. We had a lot of problems with Doug's disability and me making minimum wage. It was very difficult to pay all of our bills. We were evicted. We lived in a motel room for a while, and then we ended up in a homeless shelter. Our kids have gone to more schools than they've been in school. I reached out to help from the housing authority and was told, oh, well, you have evictions. We were like 2 days away from moving. And then they were like, nope, can't take you. That was 3.5 years ago. And I asked why, and they said, well, you've been evicted. I said, because I can't pay the rent. We can't afford to pay the rent and the bills. I said, and that's why we need to be in housing. And they told me that they were just like any other landlord and that they wouldn't accept evictions. Most of the places want security, first month's rent, deposit, and then when you have an eviction, they don't either A, won't rent to you, or B, want an exorbitant amount extra. We can't. I make $8.75 an hour. I met this girl when we stayed in the Star Center, and she couldn't make it here either. And she went home to Ohio. She called her landlord and said, hey, I've got 2 months left on my lease. I know these people that would really take good care of the house, and they need a chance, they need a break. And that's the only reason we're here, because he didn't charge us a security deposit. There's help here, but it's very difficult to get help. You see people that are on Section 8 and getting housing help and like a subsidy for their rent, and they're still in there asking for help, and the people that work every day and try, they don't get the help that they need. And I think it's unfair. I feel like we're in the middle. We're not poor enough to be able to get help, and we're not rich enough to be able to save ourselves. I guess that's the best way to put it.